If you're looking for instructions on how to set up and use an external hard drive on an Xbox, you've come to the right place. In this video, I'll explain how to correctly format the drive and how to move games back and forth between internal and external storage. These days, games are taking up more and more space, but the good thing is that you can use any USB 3 drive on the Xbox. And the way to tell if the drive is compatible is the blue plastic inside the connectors. It's subtle, but a quick and easy way to visually tell which hard drives will work. And with portable drives like this, you won't even need an AC power supply. I can also assemble my own external storage by inserting a raw SSD into this 2.5-inch enclosure from Orico. This method can save money, but prices are still high depending on the size of the SSD, especially when you compare that to traditional spinning drives, which are much less expensive. You can also buy SSDs like this WD Black D30, which are plug and play. SSD stands for solid state drive, in case you didn't know, and you'll definitely get faster transfer speeds with something like this. No matter what you choose, here's how you set it up. With the external storage plugged in, the Xbox will ask me to configure this drive. If I choose Use for Media, the Xbox won't have to format the drive. That's because it's currently set up to store only photos, videos, and other files. But it won't work for Xbox games. However, it will work on a Windows computer because it's typically already formatted to work on PCs. But to use it for Xbox games, I'll select the Format Storage Device button. Before I move on, here's something you need to know. This will erase everything on the external hard drive and reformat it to work only on the Xbox. It'll no longer be recognized on Windows computers. So keep that in mind. Here, I can rename the drive for easier identification. Giving the drive a unique name really helps when switching between internal and external storage. When done, select and click on the arrow at the bottom right. On the next screen, I need to tell the Xbox whether I want new games downloaded directly to the external drive or continue saving on the internal storage. Choose your preference here, but for now I just want to keep downloading to my internal storage. On this screen, I can cancel or begin formatting. I definitely want to use my external storage for games, so I'll choose Format Storage Device. And pretty quickly, the Xbox will confirm my new drive is ready to use. At this point, managing storage is an important thing to know how to do. And since I chose not to install downloaded games on the new drive, I can manually move them to free up space on the Xbox. Here's how to do it. On the home screen, navigate to the My Games and Apps button and hit A. In the Games tab, I'll select a game to move. Let's do Battle Islands. When I press the menu button on the controller, a pop-up window will appear. Here, I'll select and click on Manage Game. If I choose to copy the game, the original game file will still remain on the internal drive. Or I can select Move All. Using Move All will transfer the game files to the external drive and delete it from the original location. I want to move the game, so I'll click A on the Move All button. On the next screen, I'll select Move to confirm this is what I want to do. I can now watch the transfer progress, and the time it will take depends on the size of the game. When it's done, I can see Battle Islands is now on the external drive. I can also move games from the external drive to internal storage on the Xbox. So after confirming I'm actually working on the external drive, I'll select Move All or Copy. Again, I'm just going to move the game. Here I'll confirm to start. While I'm waiting for this to transfer, I want to let you know that I've listed all the drives seen here in the description so they're easy for you to find. And now the game has moved back to the Xbox. It's all pretty easy to do, and hopefully you're able to follow along to better manage your Xbox storage. But here are some final tips. The external drive will work on all Xbox One consoles. It'll also work on Xbox Series X and S, but not with newer generation games that require storage through its dedicated expansion slot. Those games need faster data speeds that USB 3 can't handle. Next, if you choose to download games directly to the external drive, keep in mind that your download time will most likely take longer. And remember that a hard drive formatted for Xbox gaming will no longer work on a Windows computer. To make it compatible on a PC again, it will have to be formatted back to the NTFS file structure. And this final tip is a good one. An external drive can be moved to a completely different Xbox. Simply unplug it from the console and connect it to another Xbox. Then, after you sign in on the new console, all your games will be available to play from the external drive. This is really great when going to a friend's house or upgrading to a new Xbox console. If this video was helpful, please give me a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all my weekly videos.